Welcome to the Video Workbench Classic Series instructional video, How to Build World War II Aircraft.
Japanese interior colors are somewhat tricky to replicate. Some interiors were painted light green, while others were painted a metallic blue. I'll replicate the metallic blue by spraying a primer coat of Floquil Old Silver. Then I'll finish with Pactor Royal Blue, but I will mix only 30% blue pigment to 70% thinner. Also, and this is important, when you're normally spraying, you're usually around 30 to 35 pounds per square inch. But in order to do this technique, you need to be able to vary your pressure down to around 11 pounds per square inch. Our monogram B17 doesn't require as much work. Monogram and 1/32nd scale Revell products have so much detail molded in, you need only paint and highlight them, as I've described earlier, to achieve convincing results. Similar treatments should be given to wheel wells, engine cowlings, and other painted areas. Our basic interior color is zinc chromate, and this was the standard for U.S. Army Air Corps aircraft during World War II. You'll find wide variations in the actual color, ranging from a greenish color all the way to a yellowish color. Generally, instruments, boxes, and the like inside the aircraft were painted flat black. In order to liven up the engine, we're going to add just a little bit of detail that hasn't been molded in already. In order to add the detail, we'll just use a piece of kit sprue and turn it on our Dremel tool. Once I remove my turned part from the Dremel tool, I merely drill a little hole for a plastic mounting pin in the part, and I drill a corresponding hole in the side of the Merlin engine casing. Although I don't know what that part is in the picture, I added it because it looked like an interesting piece of detail. My next step is to drill some additional locating holes so that I can mount a little bit of extra tubing and wire just in order to dress the engine up and make it look more interesting. We'll go ahead and finish drilling some holes, but before we actually mount the wiring and plumbing detail, we'll paint the engine first. Merlin engines for Royal Air Force aircraft were usually gloss black with unpainted steel bolts. To break up the monotony of the overall black, I will dry brush with Floquil Old Silver and shade with dark brown pastels. Engine exhausts are painted dead flat black, oversprayed with a light dusting of rust, shaded with burnt sienna, and then burnt sienna for a realistic appearance.